So let me give you some briefing on this workshop. As a background, IIT Bombay runs several missions under the National Mission on Education using information and communication technology. A specific project called T10KT is a project under which we train a very large number of teachers across the country. T10KT stands for train 10,000 teachers at a time. So we have the capacity to train 10,000 teachers at a time. Let me very briefly tell you the modus operandi. 10,000 teachers apparently cannot come to IIT Bombay. So they assemble for the two-week workshop conducted under the aegis of ISTE, Indian Society for Technical Education. This is a two-week workshop which is conducted at about 250 to 300 remote centers. So teachers assemble at these remote centers in 30, 40, 50 numbers. And all 250 remote centers are connected on internet to IIT Bombay. The subject-specific workshops have interactive lectures in the morning delivered from IIT Bombay. All participants across these 250 remote centers can interact with our faculty, can ask questions. And if you are asking a question from, let's say, Odisha or West Bengal, not only you and your class sees and hears the question being asked and answered being given, all 10,000 participants everywhere are able to see both the person asking the question and the faculty member answering the question. In this way, we try to simulate a live classroom across the country. In the afternoon, the local remote centers conduct tutorial discussions, assignments, labs, wherever relevant, etc. These are conducted under the supervision of a workshop coordinator who is appointed at each remote center. The workshop coordinator is typically an expert faculty member from that remote center. There are 250 remote centers, so most of them have expert faculty for a subject. Now, how do we ensure that the tutorials and labs are conducted in exactly the same rigorous way as we do them at IIT Bombay? To ensure that, we collect all these 250 coordinators to IIT Bombay physically for 1 week orientation. And those 250 coordinators actually undergo the same kind of labs and tutorials that are conducted here under the guidance by the IIT Bombay expert faculty. Then they also decide what syllabus to cover, et cetera, et cetera. Then these coordinators go back to their respective remote centers, set up the labs, set up their tutorial sessions appropriately, and 2 months later, the main workshop starts in the way that I just described. We started with 1,000 teacher training program. We scaled it up in 2012 to 10,000 teachers training program because the number of teachers in engineering colleges is extraordinarily large. As you know, there are more than 5,000 engineering colleges in the country, and the number of teachers who need to be trained are very large. Why I tell you all of this is that this is the methodology that we have found successful in the government feels that this is the methodology that should be used in training people from different streams as well. We are also adopting massive online open courses, and a variation of the training workshop that I just mentioned is underway, wherein the 10,000 participating teachers actually work online for 5 weeks, and then they come for face-to-face interaction at the remote centers only for 1 week, so that they minimize the total time that they are away from their workplace from 2 weeks to only 1 week. This is the model that we propose to use in future. As I said, the government wishes to use this methodology to train people in different streams. We are conducting, for example, a workshop on cybersecurity for trainers who will train about 4 lakh information security officers required in the country in next 3 years. It is to the credit of Mr. Praveen Prakash, the Joint Secretary at MHRD and the Mission Director, who suggested whether IIT Bombay could conduct a workshop for best accounting practices as part of the capacity building. Now, frankly, IIT Bombay has no expertise in accounting. We have no faculty members who can authoritatively talk about accounting practices and so on. But like all of you, we also need accounting, we also do accounting. I was quite surprised when Mr. Bakshi told me that the accounting practices in many of the centrally funded institutions, and indeed in many educational institutions, are not running as per the best practices today. And that is the reason why they wanted to conduct a training program, an orientation program for all the people who handle accounts in various educational institutions. Now you can imagine how many people would there be. Just take higher education, 36,000 colleges. Arguably, most of them are in private sector. But in good accounting practice, private sector, public sector doesn't matter. Good accounting practices are mandatory everywhere. So we need to train, even if you imagine, just two or three people from every institute of higher education, we need to train more than a lakh of people. How do we train them? We cannot train them 35, 40 at a time in the conventional way. So it is best that we use this opportunity to use the information and communication technology. Now you will probably suspect what I am arriving at. You represent major institutions in the country. It will not be incorrect to say that after this orientation program, because most of you would already be following some of the good practices, some of you would require perhaps a reorientation, a strengthening, but all of you can act as workshop coordinators in future workshops, which will be held from your colleges as remote centers. And 10,000 people of your kind will assemble in these 150, how many institutions are represented here? All right, so we'll start with 150 remote centers. Now you don't know what a remote center is, you don't know how the remote center will function. In the course of this workshop, we will steal time from the regular schedule for half an hour somewhere here and there, and we'll inform you how that can be arranged. But in future workshops, we would expect all of you who would become complete stalwarts at the end of this workshop, so we believe, you should help the government, you should help the country to encourage all our colleagues elsewhere in the nation, in other institutions, to adopt these best practices. So this is the background. Now, as I told you, I had no clue on how to conduct a workshop on accounting practices. Fortunately, Mr. Bakshi, let me introduce Mr. Bakshi here, who is the advisor in the MHRD. He suggested that the best expertise available with an Institute of Chartered Accountants. And then I said, yes, of course, because I have a friend who belongs to that institute. He was with me on the Bank of Baroda board, Mr. Amarjit Chopra. If I'm not mistaken, he was past president of the association. And I immediately remembered the methodical scrutiny that he would subject all the Bank of Baroda accountants to as the chairman of the audit committee of the bank. So I also contacted him, and fortunately for me, he says he will definitely come here. He is not here with us today. We had actually identified four faculty members. Let me read out their names. Mr. Amarjit Chopra, Mr. Pankaj Goyal, Mr. Anand Banka, and Mr. Shyamlal Agarwal. Let us give a big hand to all these four names who have agreed to come here. Now, out of them, we have Mr. Shyamlal Agarwal with us. Let's give a big hand to him for coming all the way. Mr. Anand Banka, whose sessions start tomorrow. But let me tell you, when I had the first meeting, it was Mr. Anand Banka and Pankaj, right? Two of them came, they spent almost 2 or 3 hours here, first of all giving us faculty members some gyan on what accounting is, and then deciding on what should be the topics. Like us teachers, what I was very pleasantly surprised to find is that like all of us teachers in IIT Bombay, they also said that the time is too short and too many things are to be covered. So we share the same spirit. Of course, we somehow are able to manage that in the given time, how best to utilize that time, and that is how these faculty colleagues of ours have done. I use this opportunity to thank the association and also thank Mr. Agarwal, Mr. Banka, Mr. Amarjit Chopra and Mr. Pankaj Goyal for sparing time. All of you would know that chartered accountants of their caliber would be extremely busy people. It's not easy for them to find time, but they have spared their time. Of course, they have arranged the schedule such that somebody who comes from long distance would spend a time completely and then go back. I am thankful to them. I would now request Mr. Agarwal to say a few words on this occasion.
Good morning, everybody. Professor Saab, उन्होंने इतना बड़ा इनिशिएटिव लिया है. He has taken a very good initiative for this purpose. I think such initiatives has to be taken around the country in a different and in a lot more manner. So I am highly thankful to you, sir, as a member of the society, that you people are here to take such initiative to educate the mass institutions at a large sector. Mr. Bakshi sits in Delhi. Normally, we have been regularly talking day by day that we have to keep some program. So basically, we have Institute of Chartered Accountants of India is a legal body, statutory body set up under the Act of Parliament. So this body, rules the accounting and auditing practices in the country. It makes the accounting standards and auditing standards to be applied throughout the country in all sectors, education and other sector as well. Normally, it is not that the accounting and auditing is meant for the business, trade and commerce only. So this is a normal thinking, but the things are very different. When we have the course of accounting in the 10th standard, I think 10th is the course starts. So there we see that account, when you go to the basics, I will start when the session takes. The basics of accounting is that accounting is applicable at every place, even starting from the family, to the all corners of the world. Anywhere we have to have an accounting, applicability. And the basic concept of accounting, once we understand, I don't think you will leave any gap to understand any transaction which is carried in your life. So this is a very important subject, though taken delayed by the ministry. I have taken charge. I am elected member of the council. We have a council of, in the institute. There are 40 members in the council. So out of 40 members, 32 members are elected throughout the country. All members, chartered accountants, more than 2,40,000. They vote in different sectors, east zone, west zone, north zone, like that. And 32 members are elected throughout the country. 8 members are nominated by Government of India. They are secretaries, that is secretaries, on Government of India. So this 40-person council sits normally once in a month, 2 days, 3 days. And we make out, we come out with a policy on accounting and auditing and financial management, taxation, et cetera, lot way. So this is a regulatory body. And under this regulatory body, and this year particularly in 2014-15, I am elected member from the central zone. You have 7 states: Rajasthan, UP, Bihar, MP, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Uttarakhand, like that. So I have been given charge for this 2014 as a chairman of Professional Development Committee. So as a Professional Development Committee, we work with the ministries regularly. So Mr. Bakshi and we are, with this department, we are regularly working all the way. So this came in the way, and I am very lucky that to meet Professor Sir, a very high dignity here. And myself here, I'll take, more from you instead of giving you something. Whatever I know you, that is, all general. And for me, it is normal. For you, it may be a specific thing, but we normally carry out in the routine manner whatever things are there. But I think, as discussed, with Mr. Bakshi and all others regarding the accounting, we'll go by the concept. And with the concept, I think I have given 2 hours here, because I was just to attend the inaugural session only as institute representative. But, whenever I go, because I belong to a small village in the country, and I have seen that, the concept of accounting, whenever I go, I definitely take 1 lecture on it. Because people are terrorized for this accounting. Technical people and other people they think very differently. And what I take is, it is the simplest thing in the country to understand and to implement. So that concept I wanted to give, and that is why wherever I go, I normally, why we go for the accounting meetings and, auditing meetings and all meetings throughout the country. But anywhere I find a time in institution, I go and spare 1 hour just to, come out with the concept of accounting. So that will take. And I think I am lucky enough to be here within you, and I am thankful to the IIT and all these organizers to give me the opportunity to be with you. And I'll feel very happy to share my thoughts. Our Hindi mein kehte vidya jitna kharch karte utna badhta hai. So I am of the view that maximum interaction with the people will make me more boost to have more interaction with the people throughout the country, and it will be definitely an event for me to be remembered in my life, and will definitely give what best I had in my life of accounting profession. 33 years. I am 1981 born chartered accountant. So I think 33 years are going to complete. So whatever I have learned in my life, I'll try to give within 2-3 hours. And thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Agarwal. And thanks for coming all the way. Since our friend Mr. Banka is here, I would request him to say a few words. He will, of course, be spending a lot more time with you later. All the best.
Hello, friends. I'm glad to see so many people from different parts of our country. Especially when, last round of voting is still left. I think it's on 12th. So, tomorrow is the last round, but quite a few people made from, all parts of our country. I'm glad about it, especially for learning accounting. As Mr. Agarwal said, accounting is pretty easy for, as a concept, if you take it, it's pretty easy. And it's bread and butter for us. So, we have to make it easy. So, that's what we are here for. I'll be spending some time with you almost every day, and the last day is entirely mine, and I hope you all will be able to bear with me, and that's when I'll be able to share my thoughts with you. I'll end up my speech today. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Mani, and thanks for coming. Although he does not have a session, he was kind enough to visit us today for the inaugural function, so thank you, Mr. Bank. May I request Mr. Bakshi to say a few words on behalf of the ministry?
Respected Professor Sahab, Mr. Agarwal, Mr. Banka, and friends. I welcome you all in this orientation program. I'm very sad that the number we expected, we have not got it. Now, you see, it's very difficult to organize a workshop. For the last almost 1 year, we are trying. But when it materializes, and though I am sending my invitation, provisional invitation, way back, I think 2 months before, I send it first. But the response I have got, it's a discouraging. But still, it's a quite a good number of you have come. Now, the reasons they have quoted, or some of the institutes have quoted, like say, audit is coming, finance committee meeting is due, account is being prepared. Now, if you slightly go back, you will find that from this year, 2013-14, now, 13-14 is over, now you are preparing account as per the new accounting format. So, this workshop was actually forced on. Professor was telling, no, we don't have time, we have this and that problem. I said, no, this is very important because the new format is being implemented. So, there are a lot of challenges. We are getting in writing also. Some of the things I have brought with me also. A lot of problems are coming up. So, I said this training program will help everybody to understand different nuances of the new format. Though in the last day, I will make another announcement. Today, I am just holding it back. So many things are also happening. But anyway, the ministry wants to do more. The number is enormous. We want to reach out to everybody. It's not only the government sector. The objective is to go to the private sector also. That means each and every educational institute should get covered. That's why this talk to teacher program has been. This is the suggestion of the secretary. Initially, it was decided to have it through ABU. Professor, Bijlani is to coordinate. Professor Bijlani is to coordinate, so we went to the IKAI office also, we had a meeting, we installed ABU there, it was decided to upload from there. Then secretary suggested, no, you use the talk to teacher program, it is more effective, more reliable, and the studio is very good. So that's how it is landed on IIT Bombay. Initially it was not, IIT was not in our picture, was somewhat different. ABU platform and IKAI Bhavan, Delhi. So, secondary higher education, he changed it. So, ministry is very interested to bring reforms in the accounting sector. Our experience and the records we have, a little bit survey I did, it's very dismal. The accounting practices followed by many of the institutes are not comparable with anything. Some of them is still following cash-based accounting. Anybody using still cash base? I see you. There are many few, and the accrual system, though everybody is talking about, but what type of accrual accounting? If we go back to the survey report, it is quite discouraging. We want to change it. Ministry is very much interested. Ministry is very sincere in their effort. So we need everybody's cooperation. All institutes, everybody should come forward to make it a big success. So we have been allotted here 5 days. We have got very good faculty from IKAI. IKAI is supporting us very much. We have already sent 3 booklets, I understand. Working group report, training materials, volume 1, and then practical approach to, implementation accounting standard. Though I did not get any confirmation from anybody whether you have received it or not, but I hope all of you have seen these 3 documents. It's very important documents. And also, during this course, I'll be circulating more and more survey format, small format. Please respond to it and return it to me. Because on the basis of that, few more decisions will be taken. And also, we will try to involve IKAI to develop the accounting standards we are supposed to use. Because everything is not applicable to us. Only few accounting standards are applicable to us. So in their practical approach, they will cover only those accounting standards and elaborate it, make it easy to understand and implementable. So, and the faculties are quite cooperative. Please interact with them. So much you also gain, I also gain, and everybody gets the benefit, and professor also gets some satisfaction that his first initiative has become a roaring success. Depending on that success, I think it will be carried forward. We want to reach to millions of school and millions of accountants across this country. Thanks to all. Thank you.
I do not know how many of you realize the underlying threat in his last words. He says millions of people have to be reached. He says he is thankful to IIT Bombay for starting this, and he hopes IIT Bombay will continue. My problem is I am primarily required to train teachers in engineering and science colleges, and that is our mainstay. However, I'm very happy to do the ministry's bidding because I understand how important the accounting practices are. I was quite surprised when Mr. Bakshi told me that many of our educational institutions do not follow double entry system of accounting, which was quite surprising to me. I thought that was a standard thing. In fact, in our interviews, when somebody with a commerce background comes, the standard question I ask him is, if I go to the bank to withdraw 500 rupees, what would the cashier credit and what would the cashier debit? They can all say they will debit my account, but they don't say they will credit the cash, which is a simple double entry requirement. So our conventional education in commerce degree is perhaps inadequate to train people in even simple accounting practices. It is expected that stalwarts like you would take this mantle forward. But let me share, although we are 8 minutes late, I will take only another 3 or 4 minutes, but I think what I'm going to tell you is important. Mr. Bakshi mentioned some circulation of some books. I would like to know whether these books are available in PDF format on the internet or not. Now, I train 10,000 teachers. We don't send them books, we send them e-books. We expect them to read on internet. In IIT Bombay, we avoid printing of paper as much as possible, not just to save trees, but also to save time. And to save time for circulation, save time for people to read. Now, it is in the educational sector, the use of internet as a carrier of information, as a carrier of knowledge, is well established. I would humbly submit that in all other areas of knowledge activities such as yours, the use of net should be extensively done. Associated with the use of net is the use of computers for state-of-the-art accounting. Now, how many of your institutions do not have completely computerized accounting systems? Yeah. There is no problem. IIT Bombay also did not have a regular accounting system which was fully computerized. When I say fully computerized accounting system, That means there is not a single ledger maintained to enter any information. Not a single physical ledger maintained. So there is no issue, by the way. There is nothing to feel bad about it, because the whole world used paper-based accounting till very recently. The banking sector, with which I am familiar with, was the first one to adopt computerized accounting. But increasingly, all other segments are also doing that. And it is important to do that. That is because A, it guarantees much better accuracy. B, it has complete traceability, because you have login IDs, so you can trace the entry, who has made what entry, when, at what point, from which machine, and so on. Of course, we do not have sometimes the accompanied discipline. Like, I remember when I was advising State Bank for their bankmaster computerization in 86-87, me and my colleague Prof. Sarda went to one branch, and we found a slip there with some funny letters written there, and I was wondering what it was. It turned out to be the password of the clerk who had gone for a cup of tea. And he had asked his colleague, ki koi urgently customer aa jata hai, toh ye mera password hai, entry kar dena. Now, giving password to anybody is considered giving your signature to someone. It is just not done. But this will take a long time for us to acclimatize with. It is very, very important that in modern days we use computers to the hilt, not for anything else, but simply for increasing our own efficiency, simply for increasing our own effectiveness. I remember the early banks which adopted Bankmaster in State Bank of India, they could close the accounts at 3:05 when 3:00 was the closure of all transactions. And this, the clerks told me, never happened in their lives earlier. In fact, Mr. Lakshmi Narsivaya, who was the chairman of the Union of State Bank of India, who were opposing computerization, personally came to meet me in Hyderabad and told me that all his colleague clerks are much happier now that the computerization has saved a lot of their time. I would request all of you not only to understand from the stalwart faculty members the essentials of the modern practices, but please go back to whatever is the extent of computerization in your accounts. Please extend it as much as possible to make it fully online. Let me tell you that in IIT Bombay, I was associated with early efforts, and it's not an easy ride. It took a lot of time. It took a lot of time for my programmers to understand what accounting is. It took a lot of time for my accounting staff members to understand that they can do without a ledger, without a signature, that a digital signature is as valid and as guaranteed as anything else. It takes time because it requires a mindset change. But let us use this opportunity. And as I told you, I would expect, if not all of you, most of you, to go back and prepare your own institution to become a sort of local hub where the teachers from the, the accounting experts and the accounting colleagues of yours from other colleges can assemble in future workshops. Please understand, it is important to use technology even for such training. Physically, only 150, 200 of you can come at a place. 10,000 people cannot come. Physically, our colleagues, however enthusiastic they are, they cannot train 10,000 people one after another. They also have limited time at their disposal. We have found our method to be quite effective. Surely, it is not exactly equal to face-to-face training. But it is better than having no training at all. It also amounts to significant reduction in costs. Since you are all accountants, I would like to share that with you. The standard IST norm for conducting a workshop for 35 to 40 teachers for a two-week workshop is 14,000 rupees per participant. Most of that cost is spent in travel of the people who come from all over the country, 35, 40 numbers in an institution, their food, their stay. There are 4 or 5 expert faculty who would come to train them, like our people here. Now, those faculty members, you have to acknowledge the time that they are spending. You have to give them at least a token honorarium. You have to arrange for their travel. You have to arrange for their stay. And that cost gets amortized only over 35 or 40 participants. And therefore, the cost increases significantly. When we started 1,000 teachers training program by assembling 1,000 teachers at 30, 40 remote centers, we cut down significantly on the travel cost. And we could amortize the expertise and experience of the expert faculty here. Their cost could be amortized over 1,000 people. We brought down that cost to 9,000 rupees per person participant. We further reduced it when we increased it to 10,000 teachers. Our estimated budget which is approved is only 6,200 rupees per participant. This is less than half of the cost that government has approved for ISD workshop. More importantly, by further tweaking it, by saying that a two-week workshop need not all 2 weeks be face-to-face. 1 week equivalent of work can be done by 10,000 participants spread over 5 weeks on internet. The first such workshop is being conducted as we speak. 9,400 teachers have joined that workshop on computer programming. They will be working online for 5 weeks from tomorrow onwards. Every week they will be doing an assignment. Then they will come for face-to-face interaction for 1 week in 280 remote centers. The 280 workshop coordinators, as I mentioned, have already been trained last week by us. And even those workshop coordinators have undergone an online training of 4 weeks before they came here. We have found that method not only to be extremely effective, in fact, more effective than complete face-to-face interaction. Why? Because when people do homework for 5 weeks and they are required to submit their assignments every week, they are much more familiar with things that are coming. And therefore, the face-to-face interaction portion is used far more effectively to clear doubts, to ask questions, and so on. And guess what? We estimate that the cost of this workshop per participant for 10,000 teachers will be only 3,200 rupees per person. It is very, very important for all of us to realize that while it is very nice and good for people to interact physically as we are doing, and surely there should be such opportunities, but for consistently training large number of people, this model is very wasteful. I would rather spend more money in getting more experts to come here. I would rather spend more money to get the best people from wherever in the world. And I would rather spend that money to give you more training material and more extensive training. With this, we plan the future workshops, whether we conduct it or NITTR conducts it or whatever the ministry takes a decision. But I would appeal to you, and you would understand this better than most teachers don't understand. But you understand what cost is. And you understand what is the effective utilization of money. Every paisa of the taxpayer that we spend should go maximally in enriching people's knowledge so that that knowledge is more effectively used for people. That's the only ambition that we have. Notwithstanding anything that I have said, I am extremely thankful to all of you for having come here, for having spared your time. Although Mr. Bakshi was not very convinced on your engagements at home with closing of account, etc., etc., but I know how hard those engagements are. My own institute has problems during these months. All banks that I know of have problems during these months. So it is not easy for you to have spared your time. I am thankful for doing that. I hope you will enjoy this day. Make maximum use of this time, not only to interact with our expert faculty from IKAI, but also from the other aspects of the institute. Having come here, do imbibe some of the nice things that happen around in IIT Bombay. There are PhD interviews going on currently as we speak. There are a lot of activities that are always happening. All of you come from sister institutions. Someday I also hope to come to one of your institutions to see how you people function, not only from an accounting point of view, but from an academic point of view also. I also take this opportunity once again to profusely thank our colleagues from IKAI. Mr. Banka and Mr. Agarwal are here. Thank you very much, Mr. Agarwal, for sparing time here. I also take this opportunity to thank in advance Mr. Amarjit Chopra and Pankaj Goyal. I'm of course thankful to the ministry. A grudging thanks because they have interrupted our normal training schedule. Many of our sister institutions who are conducting these workshops are worried as to why we are spending suddenly one full week of summer activity. Summer is the only time when teachers are free, by the way. And every day of the summer, we try to utilize it either for conducting workshop for coordinators or conducting workshop for teachers and so on. So this is a heavy investment for IIT Bombay. But I am doing it not just for the ministry, not for you, but for one person's dream, Mr. Praveen Prakash, who wishes this technological approach to training to be used in as many different and diverse fields as possible. So thanks again to him in absentia, and thank you very much.